Hey folks, Whiskey Fox here, and I'm super excited today because I got something really cool in the mail. Check this out. A new knife! Stay tuned. Okay folks, so this is the Skookum Bush Tool. There was a 4.5 year waiting list to get this knife. This one is made in 01 tool steel. They are available in A2 or 3V. If you've seen some of my other videos, you know I'm not a huge fan of 3V. And 01 tool steel is definitely a favorite among outdoor woodsmen. Now, the handle is made of canvas micarta, and it's unfinished, but it still feels very smooth. You've got brass hardware here, and look at that blade, folks. Brand new, never been used, Skookum Bush Tool. Now, there has been some controversy about this knife because of the tip. Now, if you look at the knife tip, there is some goofiness going on there. On this one side, you've got what looks to be the Tonto tip modification as done by Rod Garcia. But if you flip the knife over, okay, it looks like the tip is full, and yet there appears to be a little piece of extra metal dangling off the tip there. Now, I knew this going into it that there was this controversy with the tip. The maker wanted to strengthen this weak point here by going ahead and removing the tip because some users reported after heavy use the tip breaking off. Now, I don't have a problem with that. I didn't buy this piece to show off in a museum. I bought this piece for its superior wood cutting performance with this Scandi edge here, okay? Now, this particular blade is going to be a little bit thinner than your traditional woodlore style knife. And I happen to have a Grey Wolf Knives Wolf Lore here, all right? And if we compare the thickness between the two knives, you can see that the knife on the left is definitely thicker. I was having some problems carving with this knife here, the Grey Wolf Wolf Lore. I believe that this bevel here doesn't come up high enough on the blade and allow me to get the proper angle. And the fact that the blade was thicker, I think was also giving me some problems. Down here in Florida, we have some really hard woods and I was having trouble carving with this knife. So I decided it was time to let her go and step up to the plate and get the Skookum Bush Tool, because you know this is more of a Puko style knife, and I've been running this style knife for a while now, the Ray Mears woodlore style. So I decided to try one of the alternatives, was to go with something like this. Shorter blade, thinner blade stock to allow me to get more of a bite on that piece of wood that I might be working with. So I'm totally stoked about that. Folks, check out how sharp this thing is, okay? Look, I've got a sheet of paper here. Remember, I haven't used this yet, so look at that. It is like, I messed that one up. Always on camera, but all day long. This thing cuts like a laser. And, you know, I'm looking forward to it. So very, very interesting knife design. You know, always like to try new things, and I like to show you cool things on my videos, okay? Wouldn't it be boring if I showed you just the same old stuff all the time, right? So the Skook and Bush tool, folks, what do you think? Isn't it cool? Super, super cool. All right, let's talk about this sheath for a minute. This has got to be the world's ugliest sheath. Good Lord. I mean, I know this is modeled after, you know, some of the Scandinavian designs. And, you know, it's hard as a rock. So it's not pliable at all. And when your blade goes in there, it locks in there. This is like a Kydex sheath, you know, but it's not, obviously. It is a leather sheath, but whatever he's done to it makes it hard as a rock. I just think it's fugly to the nth degree. But you know what? I tried to put the knife in this sheath, and because of this, the grip here on the micarta, it won't fit in here. I mean, not really well, okay? So if I want to step up to a different sheath, I'm going to either have to make one or have someone else make one for me. I thought I might be able to just get, you know, one of these, which are fairly common, and just use that, but that's not going to be the case. And that's okay. But to tell you the truth, this sheath here is growing on me. If I can find some way to, you know, make a knife attachment here, and I don't like dangler attachments, but if I could find a way to make a belt attachment here, you know, I might give this a shot. You know, I might not be too offended by it, but just initial impressions are, oh my goodness, it looks like a dried up banana leaf or something. It's just, anyway, so one last look at the Skook and Bush tool, and this is just, you know, a preview style, not a review, because I haven't used it yet. One last thing. The maker has left this spine sharp in order to create sparks off your ferro rod. And that's great and all, but it does leave this unfinished impression along the spine here. It seems like, I don't know if you can make that out, like right there, it gives this rough feeling, not the most, you know, beautiful, polished, shiny, everything's well-rounded kind of a knife. This, right out the box, says, hey, you know, go ahead and use me. Use me and abuse me. Cut some wood, make some furniture, make some kitchen utensils. Survive with me out in the wild if you get lost. And that's what this knife is all about, folks. One more little thing before we go. We're gonna go ahead and get some weight on us. Figure out what this little bad boy weighs. A knife by itself is reading 7.4. Now that's kind of weird because I thought this knife was going to be in the 6.5 ounce range, and something else is weird. I keep getting different readings, like wherever I put the knife. I've even gotten like 6.9 on here. You know, these are all handmade one by one, so I'm sure there's going to be some variance in length, in thickness, and in weight. So I happened to get one that was a little bit heavier than many of her cousins, and that's okay. Just for shits and giggles, let's go ahead and weigh the sheath. Okay, all together, knife with sheath. All right, 10.4. Little bit heavier than I thought she was going to be. I was looking at, you know, was this going to be a 6.5? All right. And we're going to just see what this guy weighs. 7.8 ounces. So this is a little bit of a heavier knife. It's longer, the blade is thicker, the wooden scales. I think what makes this, part of what makes this knife heavy is that steel welded plate on the back. And the point of balance is, because of that steel plate, is more towards the back of the knife. I've had knives that are more up front for balance. But because the blade is smaller and thinner at the top, having that weight near the bottom makes this feel effortless, and I think it's going to be a pretty good carver. We'll save that video for something in the future. But just wanted to show you today, folks, okay? Anyways, my name is Whiskey Fox, and I do appreciate you tuning in. Today we've looked at the Skookum Bush Tool. I want you to go ahead and leave me a thumbs up if you liked the video. Subscribe if you're not already. Share with your friends if you thought this was cool. And if you want to talk about this knife, then certainly go way down in the comment section and have at it, and I'll respond in any way I can. And anyway, I do appreciate you folks a lot. You guys have a good day. Take care.